Imagine a self-contained structure that provides food and shelter for its inhabitants, treats waste, houses systems to produce electricity and water, and supports long journeys at sea. A ship is a floating marvel, a feat of engineering in and of itself. Now turn that ship into a platform for research, and you have a floating laboratory with tools and sensors that enable us to probe into all realms of the ocean. The regional-class research vessels are designed for the future of coastal science, designed for science at sea.
Anytime you're awarded a grant, you're very excited, but there's also this realization that we have a big job ahead, and this particular project with a 10-year scope, we realized we had a lot to do and we had a lot of pieces to put in place and people to hire. It's at times been daunting, but also very exciting.
Typically, NSF builds boats like every 15, 20 years, and they'll be around for 40 plus years. So you have to be able to build something that can be used for things you never imagined. One of the biggest issues that we have to deal with is there's a lot of different equipment that goes on board. It affects what you end up designing because you want to keep a lot of flexibility.
In a lot of ways, building a research ship is like any other ship. RCRV is different in that we have a very tight envelope to build in terms of physical constraints, and we have a lot more equipment than what the typical ship that this shipyard would build.
At almost 200 feet in length, with accommodation for 29 crew and scientists, for up to 3 weeks at sea, the design of the regional class research vessels is a feat of scientific vision, advanced engineering, and painstaking integration of systems.
RCRV is unique insofar as it benefits from modernization of communication systems, of control systems, of green technologies, those that minimize environmental impact of working in the ocean.
The ship's engines run at optimal speed to increase fuel efficiency, and waste heat is recouped to run auxiliary systems. Ballast water is treated and sterilized to prevent the spread of invasive species. The bulbous bow and shape of the hull improve the overall hydrodynamics of the vessel. The propellers work with advanced navigation and computer systems to provide dynamic positioning, a kind of exact autopiloting. And the Z-drives are designed to reduce noise and enhance fuel economy.
We went with the variable speed generators, which allows the electric plant to operate at a very efficient point. And so there's less load on the generators a lot of time, and it really helps with the fuel savings.
We are using the highest level of emissions ratings for our engines. So we've tried to incorporate all those green type technologies to the greatest extent possible in our ship.
Building each vessel takes careful planning and precision. Metal sheets are cut down to size and fit together to form separate segments of the hull, otherwise known as modules.
We have a couple of big modules behind me, and they're actually super modules. So it's module welded to another module, welded to another module, and the super module for vessel one will be moved out today for blast and paint. Several big transporters will come underneath the ship, pick it up, and then transport it out to the yard. It's a really cool process, and I'm excited to watch.
At any one point in time, we may have 150 to 200 people here working at the shipyard as the modules of the ship get put together. So it's a pretty diverse group of tradesmen that build the ship.
There's been a handful of people from Oregon State University. We've had some people from Gloucester that were helping do the original model and design. And then we have all of these workers from the shipyard who are actually putting the ship together. So this has really been a collaborative process of how to build these ships and how to make them for science.
It's awesome to come out here and see this, and sometimes amazing how much progress is made from when I was here in May or June to now. Thank you.
The sheer expertise and dedication required from all kinds of players, engineers, technicians, project managers, scientists, is what truly carried this project from its inception as an idea, a resounding call from the U.S. scientific community to renew their academic research fleet. And despite the recent challenges of a global pandemic, new shipyard ownership, and multiple hurricanes, construction towards the successful delivery of these ships is well underway.
This process started a long time ago of, you know, really imagining what these research vessels will be like, and then moving more to the design phase. And now we are in the stage of actually putting steel together. So after this stage, we will have to put a lot of the equipment in, and we'll do harbor trials, we'll do sea trials, and we'll really have to make sure that these ships are ready to go for the scientists and the operating institutions.
What I love about the RCRV design is that comprehensive capability being delivered in what has traditionally been a larger package. These smaller vessels will be more accessible to more people to do studies in the coastal environment they haven't been able to do before.
I'm very proud to be part of this project. It's very much a team effort. There are a lot of talented people that are working together. We are entrusted by the National Science Foundation with this responsibility to serve the community, and we'll have a research vessel for probably another 30 to 40 years.